Hello guys, today we are going to study cash flow statement, which is a very important topic for commerce student. But before proceeding, let me tell you that I am Lavish Gupta and I am currently pursuing BBA as well as CA. So let's start. See, in this video, I am going to tell you guys what is cash flow statement and how to prepare it. Actually, we will study indirect method in this video and soon I will publish the video for direct method too. Okay, so what is the meaning of cash flow statement? Well, it is pretty obvious from its name that it is a statement of cash flow. Here you guys must focus on the term cash flow. Okay, see, in business, cash can either flow into the business or can flow out of the business. For example, when debtors pay their dues or when a business sells an old machinery, cash comes into the business, which is known as inflow of cash. And when a business pays money to its creditors or buys a new machinery, the cash goes out from the business, which is known as outflow of cash. So from all this, we can say that cash flow statement is a statement which shows the inflow and outflow of cash and cash equivalent of a business during an accounting period. So from this definition, we get to know about two things about cash flow statement, which are: first, cash flow statement shows the inflow and outflow of cash and cash equivalent. Don't worry, I am going to tell you what cash equivalent means. Just stay with me. And second, cash flow statement is usually prepared for an accounting period. Okay, so what is cash equivalent in cash and cash equivalents? Here you guys must understand that cash equivalent is not same as cash, but these are those investments which can be readily converted into cash. That is, those investments which have a maturity period of less than 3 months, and also such investment which should be subject to minimum changes in value. That is, their value should not be changed much during a period of time. Now let's go to how to prepare cash flow statement. Well, in order to prepare cash flow statement as per accounting standard 3, you guys need to know about 3 activities which happens in a business. These activities are operating activities, investing activities, and financing activities. While preparing cash flow statement, cash flow from each of these activities is calculated separately, and at last they are computed collectively to know the net increase or decrease in cash flow of a business. Okay, and a brief knowledge of these activities will help in preparing cash flow statement. Starting with operating activities, these are the principal revenue generating activities of the enterprise. These activities include sale of goods and services, payment to suppliers, payment to employees, factory expenses, royalty, fees, commission, etc. Next is investing activities. These activities are related to the acquisition and disposal of long-term assets and other investment which are not included in cash equivalent. Remember, I said those investments which are not included in cash equivalent. That is, those investments which are invested for a longer period of time, more than 3 months. Okay. Example of investing activities are sale of fixed assets, purchase of fixed assets, sale of investment, purchase of investment, interest or dividend received, etc. And the third and the last activities is financing activities. These are the activities which result in the change in the size and composition of the owner's capital and borrowing of the enterprise. Example include issue of shares, issue of debentures, redemption of shares, redemption of debentures, interest or dividend paid, etc. So, as I said, cash flow is classified into 3 parts, that is, cash flow from operating activities, cash flow from investing activities, and cash flow from financing activities. And in order to prepare cash flow from cash flow statement, we have to prepare cash flow from each of these activities one by one, and then at last we will combine them and we'll get cash flow statement. Okay, so this is the format of cash flow statement, which comprises of particulars, details and amount column. At the above of the format, we write cash flow statement for the year ended or for the period ended, dash 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 means for whatever period you are preparing it. For example, here we are preparing it for the period ended 31st March 2018. Okay, so now let's move inside the format of cash flow statement. So it starts with a heading which is called cash flow from operating activities. It means that firstly, we calculate cash flow from operating activities. To calculate it, we use net profit, which we get from the trading at profit and loss account. I am explaining it with some imaginable figure. So let's suppose net profit is rupees 2 lakh. Okay. And then we add to it non-cash and non-operating expenses such as depreciation, share discount written off, loss on sales of asset, provision for taxation, etc. After that, we subtract from it non-cash and non-operating incomes, such as profit on sale of assets, dividend received, etc. Okay. So after doing these steps, we get cash flow from cash flow before changes in working capital, which is here 1,95,000. Now, changes in working capital means changing in current assets and current liabilities from previous period to current period. Here in our case, from opening period of the year to the closing period of the year. So now here you have to remember that increase in current liabilities and decrease in current assets are added, whereas increase in current assets and decrease in current liabilities are subtracted. Okay. So an easy way to memorize this is to remember only that increase in current liabilities is added. Now if increase in current liabilities is added, it ultimately means that decrease in current liabilities will get subtracted. And also remember that in case of assets, it is opposite of liabilities. That is, increase is subtracted and decrease in assets is added. Got it? So after doing this, we will get cash generated from or used in operation. See, if this amount is in positive, we will write cash flow generated from operation. And if this is in negative, we will write cash flow used in operation. Here in our case, the said amount rupees 2 lakh is in positive. So we will write cash generated from operation. And then the last step of cash flow from operating activities is to subtract the actual taxation paid. And after subtracting it, we will get cash flow from or used in operating activities. Similarly, if it is in positive, we will use cash flow from, and if the total is in negative, we will use cash flow used in operating activities. Here in our case, the amount is in positive, so we will write cash flow from operating activities. So we will write this total in the amount column, and you guys may be thinking why, but don't worry, you are going to know really soon. So the next is cash flow from investing activities. As that was a small slide, so I am continuing the format on the next slide. Okay, so now we have prepared cash flow from operating activities. Now we will move on to cash flow from investing activities. Here, transaction related to acquisition and disposal of assets come. All those transactions which leads to the inflow of cash are added, and all those transactions which leads to the outflow of cash are subtracted. So some example of such transactions are purchase of assets, purchase of investment, sale of assets, sale of investment, interest received, dividend received, etc. Let's discuss each of these and whether they will be added or subtracted and the reason behind. So starting with purchase of assets. Purchase means to buy something either on cash or credit. But in cash flow statement, we only deals with such transactions which take place into cash. So here purchase of assets means buying something with cash, and when we buy something, we give cash to the owner of such asset, which leads to the outflow of cash, and those transactions which leads to the outflow of cash will get subtracted. That is, their amount will be written in negative. If you guys are not familiar with the concept, let me tell you that in accounts we can also use brackets instead of negative sign to show that the amount is in negative. Next is purchase of investment. Same as purchase of assets, it will be in negative as it also leads to the outflow of cash. Third is sale of assets. Now when we sell something for cash, inflow of cash takes place. And as I previously said, all those transactions which will lead to the inflow of cash will be added. So it will also have a positive sign. Similarly, as sale of assets, sale of investment will also be positive. Now when we have invested somewhere, we usually get interest or dividend on it. And receiving interest or dividend means cash is coming into the business. Thus this transaction will also have positive sign. Now we will add and subtract this transaction as per their sign, and the total will be written in the amount column. And same as operating activities, if the total is in positive, we will write cash flow from investing activities, and if it is in negative, we will write cash flow used in investing activities. Now third and the last is cash flow from financing activities. Same as investing activities, all those transactions which leads to the inflow of cash here will be in positive, and those which leads to the outflow of cash will be written in negative. Following are some of the examples, let's study each one by one. First is issue of share, issue of share capital. So when a company issues shares, it receives money from the public. Thus inflow of cash takes place. Thus it will be in positive because of inflow of cash. Next is repayment of debts or debenture. When we repay money to the bonds or debenture holders, outflow of cash takes place. Thus it will be written in negative. Third is redemption of preference share capital. Redemption is same as repayment. Thus it will also be in negative. Next is proceed from loans. It means taking loan from someone or from bank or from any financial institution. It leads to the inflow of cash. Thus it will also be positive. Now repayment of loan is the opposite of proceeds from loan and thus negative. Next is interest and dividend paid. See, whenever a company raises share capital or borrows loan from someone or financial institution, company has to pay interest or dividend on it, which results in the outflow of cash. Therefore, it will also be negative. Now we will add and subtract all these transactions as per their sign, and then the total will be written in the amount column. Now if this total is in positive, we will write cash flow from financing activities, and if it is in negative, we will write cash flow used in financing activities. Now we have prepared cash flow of all three activities, that is operating activities, investing activities and financing activities. Now we will add and subtract the total of each of these activities as per their sign, and whatever the total comes will be written as net increase or decrease in cash and cash equivalent. So if it is in positive, we will write net increase in cash and cash equivalent, and if it is in negative, we will write net decrease in cash and cash equivalent. So this is where our cash flow statement ends. But if you are preparing it for the exam purpose, there is actually another step. Actually, in the question, you will be given opening and closing balance of cash and bank balances. So what we will do here is, we simply add the opening balance of cash and cash equivalent, that is cash and bank balances, to the net increase or decrease in cash and cash equivalent. And the result should be equal to the closing balance of cash and cash equivalent, which is also given in question. It also ensures correctness of the cash flow statement. That's it. Hope you like this video and do not forget to like, comment and subscribe. Thank you. Stay tuned.